tiny but troublesome. Conical snails are an increasing problem for some growers in Australia's southern cropping regions.
Oh, look at that. You just got them all under the stubble here.
East of Albany on WA's south coast, colonies of snails cluster on fence posts and burrow in soil and thick stubble such as canola, contaminating harvested crops and clogging equipment.
Bloody mongrels.
Scott Smith's family has farmed here for generations, but over the last 5 years, snails in this region, and to a lesser degree slugs, have been increasing costs and decreasing quality.
We went out and bought a new seed cleaner. We clean all our canola now because of contamination. In the cereals it can be quite difficult because you can't necessarily clean the snails out of grain. We had quite a lot of wheat this year downgraded from sort of noodle and APW grades down to GP, which is very disappointing.
It's a problem measured in tonnes.
We had about 400 hectares of canola up at Copper Valley this year, and we probably cleaned out three and a half to four and a half tonne of pure snails.
Scott has grazed stock to crush snails, reduce stubble and eliminate green feed sources, strategies recommended by the Department of Agriculture and Food WA.
In this case, we can actually see that grazing a paddock has caused the stubble to be broken down, and the movement of the stock over this paddock has decreased the amount of green plant material, because the more green plant material that's present over summer, the more places there are for snails to harbour under, and also they do form a ready food source if we do get any summer rains.
Another strategy, baiting, has brought Scott mixed results.
The problem with the baiting is it's very expensive, and you don't kill all the snails, you just drop the numbers back and then you're just going to continually have a problem.
Sardis just finished a scoping study to look at the application of baits being used by fertiliser spreaders, and what they've found is that if you can calibrate your fertiliser spreader, you'll get better bait coverage.
GRDC's recent snail and slug study has now been extended into 3 years of funded research, focusing on better management and control.
We probably really need to know a way of breaking their life cycle properly and being confident that we can do it.
Growers like Scott are keen for information and desperate for solutions.
Same old story with weeds, we'd love a spray, but I'm not sure that's going to happen. Yeah.
Surveys in WA have found snails from Esperance to Geraldton. Common farming practices can aggravate the problem. Minimum tillage and stubble retention provide protection for snails, and liming strengthens their shells, building resistance to hot summers.
So it's not to not lime, it's just if you are liming, you just need to be aware of it and manage those paddocks that are being limed.
Impacts of the infestations vary.
Some growers are reporting that it's causing not just damage to crops and emergence, but it's also become a major grain contaminant. What we've been asking growers to do to decrease numbers of the small pointed snail is to bait before they seed and after seeding, especially if they're going to be planting canola into a paddock that has a lot of snails.
Some growers use burning, but erosion can be a risk.
Burning's not really an option for us because our country is light, it's quite fragile, and the district has seen a lot of wind erosion events in previous years before we all got into minimum till. Other than that, we're waiting for a silver bullet.
There is no silver bullet. It's a matter of using a number of techniques, from baiting to managing stubbles to decrease the snail population over time. Late summer, especially if we've had some rainfall, is a good time to inspect your paddocks, because areas of green are very easy to find snails under, though slugs can be more challenging to find.
While research continues, Scott hopes for eradication, knowing minimising crop damage is the key.
Very, very tricky, very expensive, takes a lot of time, and the answers for us on our lighter country I don't think are there yet.